In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the tone filter and the radial mask. The example I'm going to use is to make the park that's under the bridge on the left-hand side stand out a little bit more. So let's get started. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Add Filters, and I'm going to type T-O-N for tone, and there it is under Essential, and I'm going to click on that and add it to the list. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to expand it. And looking at the park area, I'm going to use Smart Tone. This is a very useful tool, and what it does is it will increase the brightness of things that are not so bright when we move it to the right without brightening the things that are already bright. If we move it the other direction, it will darken things that are not as dark, the brighter things, without darkening the things that are already dark. So here we go. I'm going to go ahead and click midway just to see what it does. And I can see that it's doing a pretty good job of making that park area pop a bit. Now, again, as with any filter, it's applying this across the entire image. And I only want it at the park. I think in this case, the simplest way to accomplish what I want is to use the radial mask. So I'm going to click on the little paintbrush in the tone filter. I'm going to choose radial mask. And it's telling me to click and drag to draw a circle. I'm going to position my cursor in the middle of the park area, click, and I'm going to drag out. And that's our circle. Now, the first thing that you might notice is that it's actually darkening the areas inside the circle. So what's happening is it's being applied outside of the circle, and I want it applied inside the circle. So we're going to come up to the radial mask options, and we're going to click on invert right here, this button. And that's going to make it work inside the circle. So now I'm going to grab one of the edges, and I'm going to make it a little more squat. I'm going to come to one of these little control handles here. When I get the double-headed arrow, that means that if I click and drag it, I can rotate it. And then I'm going to come here. I'm going to expand this out a bit and drag it this way and maybe reposition it here. Okay. Now, I'm going to come back up to the Smart Tone, and this time I'm going to play with both Smart Tone and Contrast. So you can see what that did. I'm going to bring the contrast up there a little bit, and I'm going to make it look like there's just a touch more sun peeking through on that part of the park to draw the eye down there. So let me turn it off and on for you. Here's with the tone filter with the radial mask off, and here's with it on. I didn't want to apply too much of it. I just wanted that one little area to be a bit more punchy, and I feel like I've accomplished that. So there you go. That's the radial mask being used with the tone filter.